There's something in our DNA, and I can't explain it, that drives us to mark our body in a way that's different from the people around us. Every monkey wants to look different than the one next to him.
These days, tattoos are everywhere.
Above my knee.
Most of my arm.
On my ankle.
On athletes, movie stars, and even elected officials. In 2015, almost 1 in 3 Americans had at least one tattoo. Just 3 years earlier, it was 1 in 5. There are now tattoo conventions all over the world, including in Brazil, India, and Egypt. But go back just 50 years, and tattoos were incredibly rare. And in a lot of places in the world, that's still true. In China, tattoos are banned from appearing on television. In Japan, tattoos are often banned from public pools and spas. And in the United Arab Emirates, you have to remove your tattoos if you want to join the army. But humans have marked themselves since the dawn of civilization.
I don't think there was one origin event or one place where tattooing was developed and then it spread around the world. I think it was more of an independent invention in many different places. We have this natural impulse to mark significant life-changing events.
Ancient human cultures that would never have met each other developed their own traditions of tattooing. There are 61 tattoos on Atsi the Iceman, a 5,000-year-old frozen mummy found in the Italian Alps. So if we've always done this, why are so many people suddenly getting tattooed now?
The face I was born with, and there's nothing I can do about it. Well, that isn't quite true.
Tattoos are not the forever scar our parents warned us about.
Tattoos on Apo Anu's body indicate that he had a high status.
It used to be convicts, carny, bikers.